Hi, my name is Dr. Khurram Pervaiz. I am a shoulder, elbow, and hand specialist with the Orthopedic Association of Central Maryland, and I work at Howard County General Hospital. Elbow fractures can happen after a fall. This could be a simple ground level fall, as in falling on the floor, or falling down steps, or falling off a tree. You would have pain in your elbow, swelling, limitation in motion. You could have bleeding from the elbow. And if you have these symptoms, it will be, you should probably go see someone and get an x-ray to make sure you do not have an elbow fracture. Going to the emergency room is probably the best thing to do, because in the emergency room, they would probably get an x-ray and find out if you have an elbow fracture, and then probably send you to the right specialist. If you're suspicious that you have an elbow fracture, then it would be appropriate for you to make an appointment with an elbow specialist so they can get x-rays, evaluate you thoroughly, and decide whether this is something that can be fixed with something simple like a cast or whether it's something that needs surgery. Elbow fractures can be highly complex technical injuries, and frequently specialized training and technical expertise are required to put these complicated injuries together with surgery. The most important thing in the elbow joint would be the alignment of the joint itself, or the articular surface. If the alignment of the joint has been affected, then it frequently has to be restored through surgery. If the alignment of the joint is okay, then elbow injuries can be treated in something simple like a sling or a cast or just immobilization for a short period of time. However, the elbow is a joint that does not tolerate immobilization very well. So immobilization is usually done for a short period of time to avoid permanent stiffness. Complications from elbow fracture surgery can range anywhere from nerve injury to bleeding to infection, swelling, and stiffness in the arm. Elbow fractures can take anywhere from 6 weeks to 3 months to heal completely. I start therapy immediately because stiffness can be a problem. I don't generally allow my patients to lift anything heavy with the arm. And initially, the most important thing is to elevate the arm to minimize the risk of swelling, infection, and wound breakdown.